Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging hour discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cucchiara, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management strategies, new construction advice, home improvement tips, and much, much more. And now, to guide you around the world of real estate, here's your host and Real Estate Radio Live team leader, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome in. Good afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Hope you're having a wonderful afternoon. Thank you for joining us. We're with you today, and just a reminder, we're with you 5 days a week. We're the only live real estate radio show 5 days a week in the Bay Area, covering the entire Bay Area. We're with you from 3 to 4 every day. You can listen to us a couple different ways. One is on the radio at KDOW, 1220 AM. You could also listen to us live online if you go to kdow.biz. However, those are all good spots, but we would love to have you download the podcast, because that way you could, for those that aren't fortunate to be able to listen from 3 to 4, you could listen to the show anytime, wherever you go, and take it with you. You go to our website at reradiolive.com and download the podcast and have it available, or you go to iTunes or any other place where you download the podcasts and your apps, your app stores, and get this and cover it everywhere. We are focused on education information. That's the objective of the show for 5 years now. That's what we do. We work really hard to have great guests like I have today. I'll introduce in just a minute. And good content and information to really help you, the consumer, make wise decisions in and around your real estate. It's pretty simple. That's what our goal and objective is here at Real Estate Radio Live. And we have a team of people in all different aspects of real estate to help you. So keep that in mind if you need any help. We're a live show. We also love your questions, interaction. If you want to talk with us today or any questions for the guests, there's two ways you could interact. One is the toll-free number, 1-800-516-1220, or the popular way is to text also. You could text any questions or comments to 408-838-9060, and those that are listening on podcasts, that's the best way to communicate with us as well. All right, let me invite my guest in today. It is Mr. Richard Zahm. He is the CEO of EquityClub. Richard, good to have you here.
Well, thank you so much, Joe.
It's a pleasure. We met last year and was very intrigued by the business model and what you guys are doing, and I know there's been some good progress. So I'm excited to hear and get an update now on what's going on with Equity Club, because I was familiar with this, but I know that, again, good to have you on the show. So, again, if you have any questions, this is going to be something I think you're going to be very interested in. If you're listening, text them or call in. We're going to take you through this Equity Club. It's just another way to use and access equity in your home that is untraditional and in a marketplace. We were talking offline before we started the show. In a marketplace where I deal with financing every day with people, there is a real need for an alternative to conventional financing, reverse mortgages, and some of the other things that are out there, and this is certainly one of them. So, Richard, why don't we get started? Tell us a little bit about your background and then your current roles and responsibilities, and give us kind of an update and about the concept of Equity Club.
Well, thank you, Joe. My background, I'm a California lawyer. I'm also a California broker. I have a lot of experience in real estate finance, real estate development, as well as mortgage lending, both commercial mortgage and residential mortgage lending. I started at a residential mortgage brokerage, then became a private money fund a while back. And then this opportunity came up a little more than a year ago.
Okay.
And I was really intrigued, first by the model, and second, I really felt it was what we need here in California, and that California homeowners could really use it.
I would agree. So tell us exactly what is equity share and how does it work, if we could just break it down for the listeners here.
Equity sharing is basically investors sharing sharing equity with with the homeowners. The simplest example could be, say, someone's trying to purchase a home here in the Bay Area, which is very expensive, say a young person, and they're unable to come up with a sufficient down payment to make the purchase. So they would go to a family member. So say they would go to their grandmother and say, Grandma, I want to buy this house. But can you put up half the down payment? And grandma would say, yeah, I'll put up half. But when you go to sell it in a few years, I want my money back, plus I want half the appreciation. So that's all we're doing. We're taking it, though, away from the family and bringing in individual investors. Reversing the model, you've got homeowners who have a significant amount of equity in their house that they would like to tap without going further into debt.
Right.
Say to pay for college tuition or whatever, to pay down credit card.
Yeah.
So what they can do is instead of borrowing against the equity, they can actually sell a piece of their equity to investors.
Right. So let's set this up for the listeners because it's really, really exciting. At the same time, it's a little bit untraditional, but it makes a lot of sense. So let's say you have, let's set up an example. Let's say you have a person that the value of their home is $1 million, which is very typical in the Bay Area here. And, you know, just for sake of our conversation, it's owned free and clear. And they want to access, let's say, $200,000. And how would that work now with Equity Club Equity? So how would take us through how that would take place? Let's say someone contacted you and said, this sounds like a great alternative, Richard. What do I need to know? How do I get started? What does this look like? What does this process look like?
Well, first they contact us to determine whether or not they've got a piece of or a property in a location where we have investor interest.
Okay.
So this is the
club.
That's the club element of it.
All right.
If they do, then they fill out a online form where we help them do it. It's very similar to a listing on VRBO or Airbnb.
Okay.
With a little bit of Match.com thrown in because we know a little bit about them. Oh, closer to LinkedIn, actually. So then we take that interest or that package, as it were, post it on an internal website that our investors, who are also club members, can look at and see if we've got a match between the investors and the homeowners.
Great. So let's say there is a match and you have an investor, looks good. So again, for sake of this conversation, someone wants to access $200,000. What's the next step? How do they process that? What are the terms? How does that work?
It varies because you're dealing with individual investors.
Okay.
So first you determine, is your property worth $1 million?
Okay.
The way we do that are through automated valuation models, which are like Zillow, but much, much more powerful.
Mm-hmm.
If you as a homeowner aren't comfortable with that, and this is where our models are different, that's why we call ourselves Equity Club. We emphasize fairness at every point. If you're not happy with the automatic or the AVMs, you have a live appraiser come out. And when you are happy that that is the value of your house, then we can back into it.
Okay. Makes sense.
So in this case, since you don't have a mortgage, we know you and you own it free and clear, $200,000 would equal 20% interest.
Yeah, right.
So then the investor would look at, okay, how long do you want this money for?
Okay.
We've got different products ranging from 2 years to 9 years and longer that you can select as a homeowner, and that will be the term of the investor with these particular investors.
Great. So then so the terms 2, 5, 9 years, let's say someone just, again, sake for a conversation, 5 years, let's just say, what could then, unlike a traditional financing, the investor agrees, everybody agrees on the terms. How does it work now? How do they get the money? Is there any terms on the money? Do they make payments on this? How does it work?
No, that's the magic of
this is
that there are no payments at any time. The homeowner continues to live in the house. In this case, the example you gave, there's no mortgage.
Right.
But they'll continue to pay the mortgages and the maintenance
and the
insurance. We'll contact them to see if there have been any major changes in their situation every quarter. And we also give kind of a rough estimate of what the home value is using an AVM, both to the investors in the property as well as you to let you know what your approximate equity position is. At the end of the term, then you've got several choices. You can either purchase the equity interest back from the investors, give them their money back plus their portion of the appreciation.
Okay.
Where you get that money, you could refinance to get it, or whatever you could. I don't know, sell stock if you have that. Whatever you choose to do, you could choose to sell the home, and then you would divide the proceeds from there. Or you could extend. The investor could say, you know, at five, I like where this is headed. Mm-hmm. I don't have anything else to go.
Right.
Let's extend.
So in a nothing's free. Everybody knows that. So I just want to make sure we're all clear on this. So this equity share concept, and then let's say they come to terms. This is what they do. So then I guess if you could explain the repayment process. They don't have payments. It's not a mortgage on their home. They could use the money for whatever they wish, right?
Correct.
So these are some big things to understand versus a reverse mortgage versus an equity line and all these different things. You could use the money for whatever you wish. You want, as Richard said, you could help your grandchild get a house. You could start a business. You could pay off debt. You could do all kinds of different things. So then the key here is maybe you could explain how the payback happens. And what I mean by that is there is a pre-negotiated, I guess, term of percentage of equities, for instance. Explain how that part works. Let's say that it is $1 million when you guys assess it, and that's based on, so let's say 5 years goes by and the house is worth $1.2 million. How does the payback take place, and what portion, or is that negotiable? Is that each individual home totally separate negotiation with that? How does that work?
We've got guidelines in place.
Okay.
To do, and that's just for this discussion. Let's say that it's dollar for dollar. So you have a 20% interest. The property has gone up 20%.
Yeah.
So you would get 20% from that, plus your original investment amount.
Got it. So the investor would get the money back, the $200,000. Plus the 20%, in other words, 20% of the new value 5 years later.
Exactly.
Is that correct?
Exactly.
Yeah.
We've got also an interesting feature that basically an online auction exchange.
Mm-hmm.
So in the event that the investor, say after 3 years, decides that he'd like to be in another investment,
mm-hmm.
he's able to transfer or sell his interest to another investor.
Interesting.
Either someone he finds on his own or someone that we find
like
online.
That.
And we use just the same process. Again, you run another AVM or series of AVMs and price accordingly.
Very good. If you're just we're going to take a break. So we have about a minute to go. We're going to take a break. But again, I'll set the stage here. This is equity sharing, and it's home equity sharing. It is a great alternative. It's equity without debt. And some people may be out there scratching their head and go, wait a minute, is this some kind of catch here? There's no catch. It's a great program that's fairly new, and you're going to hear more and more about it. But again, I'm an advocate. You know, if you've been following the show, I'm only going to endorse things that make sense for people and give them alternatives. So this is a really great program. If you have any questions, we're going to take a break. Give us a call, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text those questions to 408-838. 9060. This is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We'll be back with you to continue home equity sharing in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. I'm joined in studio here by with Richard Zahm. He's the CEO of EquityClub, home equity sharing, equity without debt. That's right, equity without debt. And if you're listening, I would so this would be in a category. If you're out there, if you own a home, you're trying to access equity from your home, and you're not quite sure, you know, if traditional financing makes sense. Maybe you own it free and clear, and you're thinking, I don't want to put another loan on there. I don't want to make payments. I don't want a reverse mortgage. I don't want an equity line. This is another product you should really, or program, I should say, you should really, really consider and think about. I am fairly familiar with it, and I would say that this is probably going to be a program that's going to help a lot of people when they better understand that they have another option. So 1-800-516-1220 if you have any questions, or you could text those questions in at 408-838-9060. In the next couple of days, over the next few weeks, as a side note, I'll be talking about, speaking of finance, I'll be talking about the four or five major banks and well, you may not want to do business with them. Boy, has that been a crazy, when you look at the number of banks over the last several years, and now it's right back to the same old thing. Isn't it amazing to look back? The hundreds of different banks, and now all the consolidation, you have four or five players, and now they're dominating, and that's not a good thing. All right, so let's get back to this. Richard, I think if you could go through again for the listeners, take us through why this is good for a homeowner, why it's another alternative, and the difference. Let's just, you know, cover the differences, how this works versus traditional mortgage, a home equity line or even a reverse mortgage.
Well, Joe, the biggest difference is that it's in many cases it can be a lot less expensive.
Right.
It just makes a lot more sense. Mm-hmm. And in a lot of situations, people who do have a lot of equity, who are very good credit risks, for whatever reason, they don't meet the requirements of the programs that are being put forth by the large banks that you
mm-hmm.
mentioned.
Right.
So even though the banks perhaps in another time would have lent the money mm-hmm. Happily, they can't right mm-hmm. now. So this is an alternative that's being used in other parts of the country. In Great Britain, for example, equity sharing is very common in mm-hmm. England, in Scotland, in Ireland. And here in California, we've always been at the forefront of real estate finance, and it was used here back in the 1980s, and there are other groups in California, other companies who are involved in equity sharing, but it's such a new an unknown concept mm-hmm. at this point that people don't know about it, so
yeah.
They don't know what to look for.
So what if let's go through the process of the market's flat or the market tanks. This is another, concept or difference than traditional. You have a transaction with the Equity Club. And again, if we use our last example, $1 million home was valued at the time. They were able to get $200,000 in this investment terms. And 5 years later, 6 years later, decide to either refinance out of it and let's say the home doesn't go up at all. It's still worth $1 million, or it goes up and it's worth $1,050,000. What? So how does that work? Does it still? It is what it is. The terms change. How does that work?
Well, the quick answer is well, it's real estate.
Anything could happen.
But if you believe in California, right. And you believe in the Bay Area, and believe in the California mm-hmm. coast, this is a very, very special place to live, and mm-hmm. people are here for a reason. The values since we've been checking the mm-hmm. the real estate records, it's like a sawtooth in mm-hmm. California. It's a cycle. It's a relatively steady cycle. Mm-hmm. But like a saw, it always goes up. So depending on how long your outlook is, and how long your investment profile mm-hmm. is, that will really be the dependent part.
Yeah, well said. Again, I'm joined today for the entire hour in studio, Richard Zahm, who is the CEO of Equity Club. We're going to take another break, but if you have any questions, once again, if you have a parent, grandparent, someone, anyone that has equity, they're trying to tap some equity, give us a call, 1-800-516-1220, text 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We're with you 5 days a week. And in studio today, we have our guest, who is Richard Zahm. He's the CEO of Equity Club. We're talking about equity, home equity sharing, equity without debt. That's right, equity without debt. I'm very familiar with this program. It's good to see it in play and being kicked off and a lot more available, and you're going to be hearing a lot more about it. I think it's a great alternative to accessing equity, especially here in the Bay Area, as we were talking about. So if you have any questions about this program we're talking about, you could call us on the toll-free number, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text 408-838-9060. And speaking of that, we did get a text, Richard, between breaks, and I'll actually got a second one, so I'll read the first one for you first. So three questions really to this one. We have a listener, Richard, that says, how much does it cost? Is there any cost associated with it? In other words, how does it differ from first mortgage? That's the second question. And the third is, do they check FICO scores and income? That's from the first caller or listener.
Very good question. On the cost, what we do is we track normal real estate or realtor costs. So okay. there's an origination fee upfront of 6%,
okay.
which is the same as a homeowner would spend to sell the house.
Okay.
The second part on the reverse question, the big advantage is it's we're just a fraction of the cost, and for your heirs, it's a lot less onerous. There's some very difficult or challenging elements to a reverse mortgage that we don't have.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, yes, your credit score is taken into account, as well as your income. And if you're retired, of course, that doesn't come into play.
So do you have to qualify in sense? Or
of course.
Do you just look at yeah,
so no, you do, yeah. And in fact, but what we're doing is you qualify on more of a human level. It's not a matter of check the right boxes or hit the right
Got
numbers.
It.
It's a matter of investors connecting with you as an individual, as a person, and saying, no, I trust this person. Mm-hmm. I like their house. I know the neighborhood. I want to share in their appreciation.
Okay. And so if we were to use the example again of 100, let's say 100,000, so they would pay 6% of that $100,000. That is that rolled into that, or they pay out of their pocket? How does that work?
That comes out front.
Up front. Okay.
So it's basically say for $200,000, it would be $12,000
right.
to get $200,000.
Okay, great. All right. So let's check the second question here. Another listener has texted in a question saying, "What happens if the property value goes, let's say, below instead of up?" And we kind of talked about that. So that's a great question. So I have another listener that texted in. What happens in that case?
Well, it would be in no one's interest to force a sale. So knowing what real estate has, and yesterday Bloomberg had a long piece which was saying that nationwide, cumulatively, we have recovered all the lost equity of the past difficult period that we had. So in the case when everyone is down, two things can happen. Everyone can agree to extend the agreement,
mm-hmm.
Or if someone does one out badly, well, they will lose. This is real estate.
Right.
So they can exit at a loss.
Very good. Let's see. All right. Looks like just those two questions. So we have what I'm going to do is we're going to take another break here, and this show is going really fast, and that's what happens when we have good information and good guests. So we're going to take another break. If you have any questions, we've had some great texts and great questions. We're talking about home equity sharing. Equity without debt. That's right. Equity without debt. Give us a call, 1-800-516-1220. Text your questions, 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We have in studio today Richard Zahm. He is the CEO of EquityClub, and his home equity sharing. We're talking about equity without debt. That's right, equity without debt It is a program that's fairly new, and we're in the process of educating the consumers, and that's what Richard's doing, he and his team. And so we're talking about it now. I am familiar with this, and I think it's a great, again, a great alternative to regular financing. You just have to understand it. But I think when it's understood and you're working with people that really know what they're doing, it's a good thing. So let's get back to Richard because we have two other questions. So the first one, Richard, was can I – I have several properties. Can I potentially look at this equity share program for my primary residence, second home, and or rental properties?
Yeah, we've designed this for your primary or second or third residence.
Okay.
And we've designed in a lot of flexibility because there's a new investment type
okay.
right now called Airbnb investing with people who just want to buy Airbnb properties or
yeah.
people who want to convert their existing home.
Right.
So this is an excellent way of pulling equity out of your home, making whatever improvements or modifications you want, and then offering it to guests from around the world.
Very good. All right, so another question, and I just got another one on top of that. So you're a busy guy today, popular guy. Okay, so the next question is another listener. Here's my question. At what point do I share the equity? I mean, so his question really is this, or their question is this, Richard. Is the equity share just in the future value of the property? In other words, if this assessment is $1 million, you have a deal, they get the money. Any equity growth from $1 million up is the equity that's shared. It's no equity that they've had in the past, correct?
Exactly.
Yeah.
You start you establish what the equity is
right.
using the AVMs or the live appraisals
right.
at the beginning,
uh-huh.
and then whatever the equity is at the end of the term that you've selected
right.
And whatever the proportion of the investment is, that's the amount that you get.
So that's a great question. Just to clear that up again, if your home was assessed or valued at $1 million and you did a transaction, you got your money, and then down the road it was worth $1.2 million when you completed that transaction, the equity share was between the $1 million and the $1.2 million, not any value that was there in the past. Good question.
Well, the interesting part here too, Joe, is the leverage element. So your mm-hmm. first example, owning the home free and clear, had zero leverage, but it got an existing mortgage already of, say, 80%.
Mm-hmm.
That same investment that you'd made, say if you had $100,000 to put into the project, you would have a 50% equity
mm-hmm.
share.
Mm-hmm.
So as a result, returns can be very, very impressive.
Yeah. Now, here's yet another question. And actually, this client, I was looking for some, we were doing a potentially bridge loan for them, and looks like they may be taking the home off the market now. So here's the other question. This is a regular listener of ours. Will this program work for him? Yeah. So this is a situation, I'm familiar with this. They had their home on the market. I think they were trying to sell it and get X amount, and maybe they couldn't get what they want, or they weren't going to get what they want. But they do have a lot of equity, and I know that. So his question is, will this program work for them? And it will, because it's their primary residence. I shouldn't say it will. I think it will. It's here in the Bay Area, and so I know they need more details. So to answer this question, they would have to contact you, right? And, of course, you guys go through the exercise.
Right, but something to keep in mind, though, is for very short periods of time, we don't have the cost advantage because we have transaction costs the same as if they had borrowed the money. So you have to have an investor saying, I only want this money out for a year, which can happen.
That's true.
For, say, a 1031 exchange, someone who needs to mm-hmm. place their money rapidly in a liquid investment, this is a perfect fit for both parties.
Yeah. No, it's a great question. That was a great question as well. So the key here is we're getting a ton of questions via text, and that's great. So here's the key. What you're going to want to do is just assess the situation, but at many of these questions I'm getting, they would all apply, and they're all very great. They're great questions. So the next step would be to, you know, contact me or contact Richard, or I could put you in touch with Richard and see if something like this works for those that are interested, for sure. Okay, so which is a couple minutes left here. Let's jump back into some of these other questions I want to get to, Richard. So can a regular lender do this? So if you know, Jim Smith goes to B of A or Wells Fargo, can they do this for them?
Well, the regular banks are in the business of lending, not equity.
Not equity,
but we've
yeah.
designed the programs to dovetail perfectly with select lenders who do understand the concept, because for a lot of them they just it's interesting because it's still such a foreign concept for them. But if you qualify for their programs, you will most likely qualify for an Equity Club investment as well.
Yeah. So the that makes sense, and we're going to be talking more about these big lenders, but we'll get to that another time. So refinance, let's say someone does a transaction and you know the agreement is 5 years, but 2 years later something changes in their life and they decide they may want to get out of it, refinance, sell their house. What changes there, if anything?
We've built in a lot of flexibility. Okay. So in the case that occurs, or you know, life happens.
Yeah,
their you know, deaths, their divorces, their job losses, the necessity for relocation for a job, for example. We do have a mechanism whereby the investors can acquire your interest from you using the same process that we did at the beginning of the transaction. So we have, this isn't locked down, in other words. Again, the approach is that we're angel investors for homes with people who believe in you, who believe in the future of real estate in the Bay Area and in California.
Yeah, I think that's well said. We're going to take our last break here in just a minute or so. So the other thing I want to get to is, so what about, and we could answer this on the other side, but I'll throw it to you now, Richard. What about tax treatment, tax issues? Is this something that if someone's going to be prepared to do, they need to check with their CPA, or are you are you able to speak on the tax ramifications, if any, on this?
No, they should definitely talk with their tax advisor, but before we go to break, I can say we have very good news when it comes to the tax side of this equation.
That's what's called a tease, so when we come back, we'll finish that one off. All right, we're going to take our last break. When we come back, we're going to finish up, so it's your last chance to text or call 1-800-516-1220. Text those questions, 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon as we wind the show down here. We're just a couple minutes left with our guest in studio, Mr. Richard Zahm. He is the CEO of Equity Club. The topic today, home equity sharing, equity without debt. And just with a couple minutes left, one more quick question that I'm going to do is I want to make sure. So the question, Richard, is how do I avoid an imputed mortgage and elements related to that, which is a great question, but it's a little bit complicated and there's a lot of kind of moving parts to that. So for the listener that texts that in, thank you for the question, first of all. It is a good question, but we're going to give out Richard's information here towards the end, and you could call him and run that by him, because there's some different components to that that'll take longer than we have time before the show ends here. So just with a couple of minutes left, maybe, Richard, you could just hit the high points of the program before we have to cut out.
Thanks. Well, we've really been focusing on the view from the homeowner side, but Equity Club has two sides, investor side. Why would anyone want to do this? Because this isn't an institution. We're really modeled after a P2P or even crowdfunding model here. What Equity Club does and what equity sharing does is it allows investors to make direct investments in residential property, which they really can't right now. So if you want to buy, if you believe that, say, Atherton or Palo Alto or Hillsborough have got a bright future, very few people have the wherewithal to be able to buy something there.
Right.
And none of these markets really lend themselves to being rentals.
Mm-hmm.
This way you can purchase a fraction of a home someplace that you like, or a fraction of a home that you like the architecture, for example, or
I think it's a great way to look at
ocean views, or you like Victorians.
Yeah.
Right now you're constrained. You can invest in a REIT, maybe, mm-hmm. but you have no say in what happens. Right. And also the big advantage for anyone who's been a landlord is you are not a landlord here. Your interests are completely aligned with the people who are making mm-hmm. all the payments for you. They're paying for the taxes, mm-hmm. the insurance, and the maintenance, and they want to take care of the house as much as you want it to be taken care of.
Right. And so what you're saying is there's really two opportunities here. You have the homeowner, someone that owns property that could take advantage of this. And you also have someone that's interested in investing. And as you said, I think you said it well. It's, you know, if you like the idea of investing in Palo Alto or Los Altos or Pebble Beach or wherever you have it, there's an opportunity for an investor too.
Exactly. The notion is here we believe in the future in Silicon Valley and California.
Right.
And we believe in the companies that are starting here. Well, if you believe in the companies, do you believe in the homes mm-hmm. here that where the people who are coming up with the advances and the technology that we're coming up with, do you believe in that? It's an investment that you can drive by every day. It's mm-hmm. in your neighborhood. It's completely transparent. There's mm-hmm. there's nothing fancy about it. There's no technology to try and wrap your arms around. There's no competition that can come in.
Yeah. Well said. Very good. All right. Before we go, Rich, I want to make sure those that want more information before we go, we have less than a minute. How would they contact you?
I'd love to talk to them on my direct email, which is richard@equityclub.co. So again, that's richard@equityclub.co.
Great. And if you're listening to the podcast later, you know how to contact me. I could always pass that information on to Richard, but that's how to get it. Richard, I want to thank you. Been a great show, a lot of good activity, and a lot of great questions. Thanks.
Well, thanks, Joe. I really enjoyed being here.
All right, we're going to have to duck out today. Again, this is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Remember, we're with you 5 days a week, Monday through Friday from 3 to 4. And stay tuned over the next couple of days and next week. We're going to talk about the big banks and why they're not good for us in the future. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We'll be back with you tomorrow. Have a great afternoon and take care.
You've been listening to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Tune in, log in, download our podcast, discover more at reradiolive.com. reradiolive.com.